This week on Top Billing's Favorite Weddings. Loved for her message of hope, Metro FM's Criselda Kananda finds safe harbor in the arms of Siolo Dudomashe. SA journalist Yolaan Begbie weds French-Beninese financier Hamet Ajimor. American businessman Jeffrey Miller finds true love in SABC news anchor Vabakshnee Chetty. From a bicycle to a carriage. That's the story of how Nicole Flint and David Van Heerden arrived at the altar. And Nokobongo Nkobu and Sibabili Magubane shared their spectacular day. Your presenter this evening is Jeannie D, bringing you the show from this garden of a home in the Constantia Valley.
Good evening and a very warm welcome to Top Billing's look back at your favorite weddings of the last year. When Metro FM DJ Criselda Kananda said I do to businessman Siolo Dudumashe, it lifted all our hearts. She had managed to fall head over heels in love with a man worthy of such a great woman.
When Criselda invited friends to a Thanksgiving celebration, they were delighted to discover it was a traditional wedding. This mother, motivational speaker and ex-nurse, had found love with engineer, construction company MD, father and son of a Xhosa chief, Siolo Dudumashe. He had proposed after just 3 months.
Her future husband is a chief, so obviously we had to also think about not making it too simple, remembering that if you're royalty, what would you do and what would it look like? So we also had to keep that at the back of our minds, even though we wanted to go very classic, you know, hence the pearls that you see on the table. I had to bring in a little of that. I mean, most brides really today are more into bling, and with her I brought in a bit of crystal, a bit of bling, but the highlight was really the pearls and the flowers and the simple lines, and most importantly the white touch, remembering that it is a wedding after all.
The cake set the theme in pearls and peppermint-colored edible roses with a filling of chocolate, vanilla, and red velvet. As for Criselda's wedding outfit, her cupcake shoes were carefully chosen to be comfortable throughout the day.
Criselda, I can't wait to see the look on your husband's face when he sees you in this dress. You look incredible.
Thank you. I can't wait for that look either. Thank you very much.
It's going to be a very special moment. What is the story behind this dress?
Well, Fred talks about a combination of being African and understanding the elegant woman that Criselda is. And I guess that was his interpretation. All I said was, I just want to look like a princess. And I'm really appreciative of it. It looks beautiful.
Siolo felt his Paledi suit was like a second skin and sees himself wearing this on many occasions after the wedding as well.
Hello, gentlemen. You're looking lovely.
Thank you.
You've already gone through all the emotions at your traditional wedding, but are the nerves kicking in all over again?
I'm more relaxed. I think I know what to expect now, and it gives me comfort at least to know that I'm surrounded by family and friends. At least people that I know who care and love me. So yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
The ceremony at the Rhema Bible Church was of great significance to Criselda, who credits her faith with being her pillar. She's helped so many through her motivational speaking, and her faith encourages and motivates her.
Donald, what were your thoughts when Criselda walked down the aisle?
For me, man, it was just the whole thing was just emotional, just watching her walk in, and I could see that she had been crying. You know, it's obviously been a very emotional day for her, but I'm really, really proud of her, and I'm so, so happy for her, and I'm glad that she's finally arrived at this special day of hers, because she's always wanted this.
Can't imagine what you're feeling. What is it like to see your mother go down the aisle after such a long journey?
It's really nice seeing her happy, you know, for once in her life, because she's been through a lot of things, and seeing her this happy is really, really nice.
What makes Siolo the perfect man for your mother?
He has a very kind heart, which really works well with my mom.
My life for you.
It was an amazing ceremony. And she looked so serene, so beautiful. And it was, I think it was those moments where you actually catch your breath and you think, this is just so beautiful.
Any words of wisdom for the newlyweds?
Woo, keep it real and kick him out of your bed when he does not make you scones and tea in the morning.
She deserves that spoiling. Criselda had been working, doing her show, right up until 2 days before the wedding. And that's how her good friends know her to be.
It's such a beautiful night to celebrate love. What has been your favorite moment so far?
You know, today has been so special to just watch our dear friend Criselda walking down that aisle, looking exquisite in that Freddie Walker gown, but more importantly, that she has found true love. We're very, very happy for her, and we wish both her and her darling husband the very, very best.
May God bless her and bless her husband, and may she be as joyful, as lovely, as bubble as she is. I wish her all the best.
Mr. and Mrs., as I call them, Dudumesh, are looking absolutely gorgeous, and you can see the love between the two of them, which is spreading throughout the evening.
I'm so happy for her. I think there's nobody that deserves love more than Criselda, because she just oozes love. I mean, wherever she goes, there's this warmth about her, and we get drawn into her. So I am so happy for them.
For me, Criselda has been a symbol of just a deep sense of resilience and a deep sense of strength, inner strength and outer beauty. That's how I would describe it.
Today, here we are, new lovebirds, newlyweds. Look, it's beautiful, man. It's lovely. Criselda, she is so happy, and we are very grateful to be here today.
Mr. Mtembo, you're a married man. Any words of advice for the couple?
They must just remain trusting and believe in one another. That's the best recipe. And be open to one another, because we're just human beings. And of course, the good part with them is that they are also people who believe in God, both of them. I think it's a good beginning.
Marriage is not a day's event. It's a house you build every day. You work on it, you establish the values upon which you want to build it, and above everything else, having a common vision about what they want to achieve in the future.
I'm here to celebrate the wonderful wedding with my colleague here. She is a wonderful woman. And I also believe the man is also wonderful, and I wish them well.
Any words of encouragement for the couple?
Life is a journey. I think they have already started a journey, but I hope they will be able to emerge, and their marriage will stay for longer and longer until they die together.
Before their first date, when Criselda asked how she'd recognize him, Siolo said he'd be wearing a hat and a big smile. May that smile remain forever.
What was it like when you saw your now wife walking down the aisle?
Oh, wow. It was a very emotional experience. I just brought tears in my eyes, and it's certainly one I would never forget for the rest of my life. And finally, we're together as one. And we're just looking forward to spending the rest of our days together. Happy days together.
And Criselda, did you get your fairy tale wedding?
I think I can write a book with just the wedding on its own. I mean, from the church, the pastor was on point. Everyone came dressed to the nines, and the speeches were overwhelming. The venue was absolutely outstanding. What more can a girl ask for? This is indeed our perfect wedding, right?
To Criselda and Siolo, you guys inspire us more than you know, and we wish you a very happy life together.
Up next, Africa unites at the wedding of Yolaan and Hamid, and an American finds love with a South African news anchor.
Word has spread about how dynamic South African women are. And once French Beninese financier Amit Agamon met journalist Yolaan Begbie, the competition never stood a chance.
Much of Hamet's business happens in sub-Saharan Africa. But what brought him all the way to Franschhoek was the biggest emotional investment of his life. To win Yolaan's attention, he had had to act fast.
How did you and your beautiful bride actually meet?
Yolaan and I met in February 15 in Boston at a business school conference. We just exchanged email, actually.
She was living in the Big Apple. He was based in Dubai and did not want to leave their next meeting to chance.
And then I'm like, okay, this time I'm not letting it go. I need to take something from her so that we have to see each other again. And fortunately, my phone battery died and she had the charger. And she said, okay, she might just come back afterwards and she will pick it up. I said, okay, I will wait. And the rest became history.
Initially a journalist on South African television, she worked in New York before following love to Dubai.
Yolaan, you look like an absolute modern day princess. Did you always know that you'd find love abroad?
You know, Joanne, I was not even thinking about the chances. I was just going about doing, you know, what I usually do, and it was totally unexpected. But I think sometimes the best things happen when they're unexpected.
How did you know that he was the one?
Oh gosh, I knew very early on. He claims that I gave him a look, and he says that he had seen that look so many times before in his dreams, but he didn't know who was going to be the one giving him the look. And I'm not sure I recall giving him that look, but I might have. So.
With Hamed having proposed in the warmth of a desert resort, the couple opted for an outdoor wedding reception.
Alet, you're known for putting together the perfect weddings, but there must be some challenges as well.
With this one, yes, it was the weather, but look now, we are truly blessed. Tonight we're going to have a magical fairy tale experience. The look and feel for the wedding, we started off with shades of metallics, and organically we've moved away from that. You will see there's a lot of soft pastels on the table, rich damask linen, which gives you that royal feel. We are at La Residence after all, probably my favorite opulent location with all the golds and silvers, and we enhanced that with the decor that we've done this evening.
On the arm of his mother, Sekirut, Hamet wore a tux sport in Spain, whilst Yolaan's dress was by Jacques Lagrange, who also did her matric dance and 21st birthday gowns.
So, as her sister, when she brought home Hamet, what did you actually think? Did he fit the impression that you had thought your brother-in-law would one day have?
Absolutely. I think the first time I met Hamet, my heart warmed for him, and he was lovely. I just knew that this was the right guy for Yolaan.
What do you wish the couple for the future?
Well, I wish them lots of arguments. I wish them enough turmoil, because I mean, we all know that it's in those moments that the relationship just gets stronger and stronger, and they look like they can handle it, by the way, you know? So yeah, we wish them love and happiness and lots of babies.
Yeah. I want some nieces and nephews, and I know that they're gonna make each other very happy.
Is this your first trip ever to South Africa?
Yes, it's my first time in South Africa, yes.
Yeah. And where exactly are you from?
I am from Benin and Ivory Coast.
Yeah. And what do you wish our wedding couple today?
Oh, I wish them a lot of love, peace, and just a really good time together, you know? It's just about understanding and learning from each other and being tolerant and patient and giving a lot of love and touch and kiss, yeah.
Ladies, what did you think of the entire wedding today?
So everything is beautiful. I like the scenery, I like the landscape, I like the place. I like the bride, her dress was wonderful. The groom was really handsome. Yeah, everything is beautiful. I wish them luck and love and many, many, many children.
The Hlangani Marimba Band Yolaan met at the waterfront set the ideal tone.
Even though this is an incredibly international wedding, it seems it's the African flavor that's coming out the strongest.
Amongst the many international guests were Yolaan's parents, aunt, uncle and cousins who all live in Dubai. Then there was the extended media family the bride has gathered in her work around the world.
You can tell a lot about somebody by the company they keep, and if this bunch of people are the ones wishing... if these guys are wishing them a wonderful future together, they're definitely going to have one.
The couple's traditional West African dress was sourced in Nigeria, made in Benin, and loved by all present.
So we're coming from France. We're just here for 4 days, but even if it was for 1 day, we'll be here because Ahmed is a very close friend of ours.
They're just such a fantastic team. I mean, they travel around, they're in Dubai, South Africa. I mean, he's in sales, she's in the media. But I think when they're together, they're sort of more than the sum of their parts. And I think that is going to be something that endears through their time together.
You know, just look at their personalities and they'll tell you they're the best match. They're both fun and quirky people, and I think they deserve each other.
The songs they chose ran from Louis Armstrong's La Vie en Rose to Brenda Fassie's Wedding Day. And you could feel the love.
I actually wasn't expecting myself to be so emotional. When I walked down with my mom, I was like, I had to look up, otherwise I would just start crying. And then when I looked at her face, it was like my heart started melting, but it was just pure joy, and here we are.
For me, the moment was just seeing everyone's faces, and that just made me feel, just warmed my heart and made me feel like we're very lucky. We are a very lucky couple to have everyone here today.
Hamid aims to enter politics, but on this night, the only party he and Yolaan cared to lead was the one that continued till sunrise.
Another media success story is Vabakshnee Chetty, who brings us the headlines every night on SABC3. More recently, she was the news when she and Jeffrey Michael Miller got engaged in the Seychelles and then married in the Winelands.
On a perfect day in this magnificent setting, the vivacious Vabakshnee was about to form her own merger with American businessman Jeffrey Miller.
Jeff and I met about 3 years ago. We've been dating for 2.5.
We met through a friend that worked at SABC, and I got introduced to her. And so we went on a blind date to the Joburg Ballet and saw Romeo and Juliet.
It certainly wasn't love at first sight. The love came softly, but it's pretty strong now, and very excited to be getting married to him.
She's amazing. Just the smartest, most caring, most beautiful woman in the world, and I'm quite a lucky guy.
An executive at a global risk information business, Jeff was confident that asking for Vabakshnee's hand in marriage would be a safe bet.
The proposal was a huge surprise. He's not a romantic guy at all. He took me to the Seychelles.
I arranged for a boat to take us to a deserted island with a picnic, some champagne and some food. So we sat on the sand, I sat next to her.
He whipped out the ring. I was so, so surprised. Took me by absolute surprise, but it was really beautiful. And he said, that's the most romantic I'm ever gonna be. And will you marry me? And I said, of course.
I'm feeling good. My biggest worry is I'm not gonna be crying at the church. I think I can hold it in, but let's see.
In this glass tent, with mountains in every direction, it was all about the flowers, floating between gorgeous crystal chandeliers. They created the illusion that flowers were growing from the tables, keeping them low and encouraging conversation.
It tried to avoid the general term theme. What was created was more a timeless look, something that Jeff and V would look at in 10, 20 years' time and really still love. It didn't want to go with anything super sort of trendy. So we stuck with a very neutral color palette, which V had actually specified, which was the mint greens, duck egg blue, and pale pink. And we just put that onto a very neutral base. So the idea is just to keep it incredibly classic and very, very, very elegant.
Despite being worried about tripping in her all-lace gown, Vabakshnee managed to make it safely down the aisle to meet Jeff, who looked every bit as dashing as she'd expected. The couple opted for a full Catholic service in a church in Stellenbosch before family, friends, and many of their work colleagues.
They look so happy together. Jeff is kind of a composed person who carries himself very well. So to see him get emotional when he saw V come out was really, really a beautiful thing for me to see.
I think they couldn't have asked for a better day or location. And just seeing two people in love, it makes you want to feel that.
After the service, guests made their way to this sweeping reception between the Helderberg Mountain and a picturesque lake.
talk about romance, you talk about the perfect setting, this really is quite perfect. And I think that, you know, when they look back and say, where did it all start? This is a great place to start a journey called marriage. So yeah, fantastic. And I wish them the best.
Speaking of journeys, Jeff clocks up many frequent flyer miles, traveling the globe for business and pleasure. But there's a sense of destiny to this union.
He left the States in 2006, right? Gallivanting around, but I believe that it was all for a reason. He had to find somebody, and that was, you know, three continents. It was 43 million square miles. It was 2.7 billion people. It was all to find V.
It was a beautiful ceremony, a beautiful reception. It was just, most of all, nice people. And a lot of Jeff's friends came from all of the United States, all of the world, excuse me, okay? And it was sort of touching for me that they thought enough of the both of them to spend, you know, 20 hours on an airplane to get down here for the wedding.
Vabakshnee's SABC News colleagues were there to celebrate and give their full support.
You know, I'm so happy that they've come this far. It's been an amazing experience to see from all the hardship that they've had up until today, where they just love each other wholeheartedly and they just committed to spending the rest of their lives together. I told Vabakshnee to love wholeheartedly, never to hold back, because we don't know about tomorrow. Tomorrow is not guaranteed. So I just wish them all of the best, and I know they'll be happy together.
The day has been like a fairy tale. It was a beautiful wedding ceremony. V looked sensational and gorgeous in her dress. I wish V and Jeff all the best with the future, good health, prosperity, children, and we welcome them anytime in our family.
To open the dance floor, Vabakshnee made a quick outfit change into a fun, flirty tea-length dress by Gert Johan Kutzier.
I'm feeling pretty good. Everything went rather smoothly, I think, and everybody's having a fantastic time.
Beautiful day, the sun was out, the mountains were in the background, we had a beautiful marquee, now we have some great live music. So for us, it couldn't be better.
From here, it was on to a mother city seaside hideaway, then to Venice and Rome for summer in Europe.
A mini moon in Hout Bay, then honeymoon in Italy. That's how you do it.
Coming up, a bicycle race leads Nicole Flint down the aisle, and Jeannie's in Sydney for one of the world's best slumber parties.
Another couple we found to be over the moon and off the scale in love are Miss SA 2009 Nicole Flint and her leading man, businessman David van Heerden.
Far from pageants and fashion shoots, Nicole and David first met on a charity cycle tour. It was her first cycling event, and though the physical demands of the race had her in tears, they started chatting. Sparks flew soon thereafter. A few months later, they were together, and a proposal was only a matter of time.
I think any guy that's bought a ring, there's a lot of pressure as to where you're going to hide it, because she's so inquisitive and she always ends up finding out all the secrets, so it's really difficult to surprise her.
We got engaged in the Midlands. There were just about four people from the venue, you know, waiters, door ladies, managers that came towards us, and I didn't know what was happening. I was like, okay, this is weird, and they had these huge posters, and the one said reason, and it had a tick, and the next one said season, and it had a tick, and the next one said lifetime, and it didn't have a tick yet. And I was like, what is this, Dave? And then there was a puzzle piece, and he'd always said, I'm his missing puzzle piece. And I looked at him, and he gave me the missing puzzle piece, and he said, people come into life for a reason, a season, and a lifetime. Will you be with me for a lifetime? And I said yes.
Nicole, left.
And kissy kissy.
The man behind the camera here was New York-trained professional photographer and Nicole's brother, Jeffrey Flint.
You should know some interesting quirks about Nicole.
You're going to get me into trouble here. I'll bring up one. When she was youngish, she had an obsession with makeup. And we've actually got a family video where she's putting on lipstick. And she actually goes into a trance for about 5 minutes putting on her lipstick. So that's one of the things she's taken with her to adulthood.
How does Dave compliment her?
She's not the neatest person. And Dave is the absolute opposite. is very meticulous and organized. And in terms of her busy schedule, he is, if I could say, her acting manager. So it works perfectly.
The elegant wedding gown in Spanish lace with detail in pearl and Swarovski crystals was a collaboration between Anel Buerta and the bride.
Anel, Nicole's the kind of woman who knows what she likes and she knows what she doesn't like. What did you have in mind when you were creating this gorgeous gown?
Nicole and I actually designed this dress together. We wanted to go for something classic, and I think we sort of wanted to do like quite a big twist on a very traditional wedding dress, but it's got a lot more drama.
I didn't expect it to be this beautiful. I think you always look at a picture and you go, okay, this is sort of what I want. But when I put it on, I definitely got tears in my eyes, especially the first time Anel put it on. And I definitely went to the right person.
The couple's choice of venue took time. They looked at 58 possibilities before settling on Cranford Country Lodge. Bride and groom are equally besotted with horses, so this Appaloosa stud farm won them over the moment they drove in.
Eve, the deck was quite simple, yet very elegant.
One of the main colors for Nicole was the dark egg blue. One of the first things that she mentioned to me when she came to see me is she loves this color. So we went out and we found all the elements that could really resonate with that color theme and golden undertones. So tonight, once all the candles are on, this ambiance is going to be absolutely magical and truly stunning.
David's best friends, Spiros and Peter, and Nicole's brother, Jeff, made fine groomsmen.
Dave, the big day's here. How are you feeling?
Hour to go and I'm jingling all over.
You're all looking pretty dapper. What inspired the suits?
We went with a bit of tweed in the design, and everybody just bringing in their own color, their color preference.
Nice.
Keeping it elegant, classic, a little blue and white. And the guys are all lean, so we went with the fitted suits from Frank Bespoke.
One of the estate's prized horses got the bride to the chapel on time, where both families gave a big thumbs up to the match.
Tamsin, what makes Nicole the perfect wife for your brother?
She's as beautiful on the inside as she is on the outside, if not more so. David is an incredibly lucky man to have Nicole in his life. She's more than a friend, she's a sister. She's very much part of our family, and David is a very lucky man, and Nick is a very lucky woman to have David as well.
Any highlights of the day so far?
I think seeing Dave cry while she walked down the aisle, because we were all waiting for that moment. Jeffrey, her brother, also had a bit of emotional time, which was also amazing to see. And just seeing her walk down, it was just, oh, you can't top it.
What encouraging words do you have for Nicole as she takes this next step in her life?
If anything, I think Nicole's one of the wisest women I know. And I think if anything, I can just say to her, you know what, go through this marriage with all the love in the world and just be yourself. I've known her and Dave for quite a few years, and they are the perfect match. They get each other, and he is truly her soulmate.
Despite a childhood spent outdoors trying to avoid homework, David has excelled professionally in the international hotel industry. A natural at woodwork and art, he's also a brother to two sisters. So Nicole is getting a man who understands women.
Louis, you watched a lot of Miss South African pageants. What was it about Nicole that gave her that edge?
I just think she's one substantial woman. Ever since Miss South Africa, she's shown it right through. And I think this is one of her second happiest days of her life. She's amazing, she's true to herself, she's true to her family, and I honestly believe this is one day that nobody will forget soon.
I need to tell our viewers that Mrs. Flint was a beauty queen in her days. So Nicole has essentially followed after your footsteps. What would you tell her today from the things you've learned in the industry?
Be yourself, stay humble, never take it to your head, and don't sleep with makeup.
I like the don't sleep with makeup. Thank you so much.
Both sets of parents are fine examples. Lisa and John van Heerden have been together for 43 years, and they're hoping David and Nicole enjoy as solid and enduring a marriage.
What are you looking forward to most in a life together?
Kids. No, I'm joking.
Oh, wait, that's what you want. No, Dave has 5 sets of twins on his mom's side, 5 sets of twins on his dad's side. So hence the fact we're wanting twins. But not just yet. We want to travel the world first together as a married couple, I think. And then, yeah.
The couple know who they are. They're aware of how much they've found in each other. And for now, they're just enjoying being together.
Definite golden anniversary material, those two. From the Midlands, next we find ourselves in Sydney at the JT1 Slumber Party, a new benchmark in the hugely popular trend of holding fashion nights in the world's hippest cities.
9 years ago, iconic editor Anna Wintour created Vogue Fashion Night Out with the goal of boosting New York's retail economy, but it's since become a global phenomenon that's turned cities around the world into a fashion lover's playground by night.
Here I am in Sydney for Vogue Fashion Night Out, and the streets are buzzing. But there seems to be only one place to be tonight, and that is the launch of South Africa's very own JT1, available exclusively at David Jones.
David Jones is Australia's premium fashion destination, offering a huge selection of international luxury brands from Burberry to Prada. To celebrate the launch, the Sydney store served up the ultimate girls-only slumber party, involving all things playful, girly and fun, and co-hosted by Australian entertainer and fashion columnist Ali Simpson.
Tonight looks like essentially every teenage girl's dream party.
Absolutely. Tonight we're welcoming JT1 to David Jones, and we couldn't be more thrilled. The brand is all about fun and frivolity, and that's absolutely what we've got here tonight. We've got topless waiters, we've got mini pizzas, nail bars, makeup stations. We've got everything a girl could want.
And now a lot of the dancers are dressed up in the JT1 collection.
Yeah, it looks fantastic. You can see the girls on the roller skates in their little shorts and their great crop top. And it's such a fun collection. You can see everyone who's wearing it feels so comfortable and is really embodying the brand.
Models, dancers and guests alike partied late into the night, powered by pizza, ice cream and pink drinks on tap.
How amazing is this party?
It's incredible. Like, I was over at the donut wall and then like at the selfie. I was getting my makeup done, my hair done. It's like insane. And there's cute boys.
The donut wall finished me off more than what the cute boys did.
I know, it's so true.
What do you think of all the JT1 gear?
I love it. I work for the brand now and I sort of came out here to host the event, support it all. And I wear it to bed every night. And like, I'm wearing the bra right now. So, I mean, I'm loving it.
A celebration of friends, fashion and fun, the party set social media on fire thanks to selfie-snapping guests.
How would you describe your perfect girls' night in?
Exactly like what this is. It would have to just be a whole heap of fun, a whole heap of friends, and anything that makes you just want to dance. So music, fairy floss, donuts, roller skates, everything. I love it.
I think just being with your girlfriends and having a chance to talk, having a chance to giggle, have a laugh.
So JT1 got it right. Fun, friends, good music and great food, and no boys allowed, unless they're super cute.
David Jones has clearly put in a lot of effort and they have succeeded. They have done so well. Everything is so beautiful.
If you look around right now, everyone's having the best time ever. And David Jones has definitely put on an amazing event.
So this party is definitely not going to end anytime soon. It is fantastic. One of the best slumber parties I've ever been to in my life. And with a little touch of South African magic, Sydney has never looked sexier.
Can more girly fun be had in one night? I don't think so.
Next up, it's Limos and Crystal by the Seaside as Nokobonga Nkomo and Sibalili Magubane share their joy.
Setting the gold standard for spectacular weddings was that of Nokobonga and Sibalili Magubane. When your backdrop is an ocean, you need to make a big splash.
If these looked like preparations for the visit of a large royal delegation, it's because construction businessman Sibabili feels he's found his queen. A good few limos were called for, as 500 guests had been invited. Many are family who Sibavili has brought into his business, and his wedding was a way to include a greater family of friends in his good fortune.
I absolutely love the color of your suits. Tell me a bit about them.
Well, navy. Navy is my color. No, I said, guys, please, let's go navy and let's not be traditional. Let's go different way. Yes. I mean, as you see us.
Apparently there's a little story about him as a little boy about how he used to get everything he wants, right?
Oh, yes, yes, true. When he was young, you know, he's always been fascinated by designer clothes. He used to cry outside the shop if his mother couldn't actually buy whatever he desired at the time. But he's always been a smart dresser since he was young.
When his beautiful bride first caught Sibavili's eye, it was in a far more modest setting than this.
How did you guys meet?
We met a church in Mpumalanga Township, Hammersdale. It was just after the service. Then they were like standing, a group of young women, but there was this one. Then I said, no, that one is the one.
For years, Sibavili introduced Nogubonga as a soon-to-be Magubane, and so it has come to pass.
Nox, you look absolutely gorgeous. Is this a Gert Johan creation?
Yes, it is.
Tell me a bit about the dress.
Well, first visit when I went to Gert, I had like a couple of pictures. I wanted a mermaid dress, long trail, long veil, like the Kim Kardashian. That's where I stole it from, and it delivered.
You're a small town girl. Did you ever imagine you'd have a wedding this grand?
No, never. Never ever in my wildest dream have I ever imagined it. But everything is just perfect. Overwhelmed, I'm grateful.
Admiring the work of wedding coordinator Sophie Ndaba, the couple knew she was the one to get this elegant wedding spot on for their guests.
You're known for quite opulent weddings. What did the couple have in mind when they approached you?
She had it quite figured out. I think she'd been planning it for years. She decided she wanted bling, she wanted fabulosity, she wanted clean, she wanted white, she wanted heaven. And I think this is a small heaven, don't you think?
Everything looks quite crisp and clean and complements the couple pretty well.
If you look at the crystals on the tables, if you look at the menus and programs, if you look at the cutlery and crockery, the cut crystal glasses, she's just got that spirit. She's a beautiful person, beautiful hearted person, you know, ever smiling, ever thinking of another person. So this, you know, they call it purity, and it's so beautiful, and it's, you know, it's bright, and it celebrates her and who she is.
Her charming qualities also inspired the statuesque, multi-layered red velvet and vanilla cake.
Dean, diamantes and white seem to be the theme here.
The whole idea here was to keep it obviously looking like a wedding cake, something pretty traditional, but very clean, very sophisticated, something that matched the rest of the decor in the room, and it had to also be edible. So every single flower, every little bud, every petal, everything is edible.
Anticipation was at fever pitch after hearing the groom arrive to the sound of police sirens. Friends and family were there to witness Nogubonga walking the bridge on the arm of her father, Kaelihle Ngobo. Several generations shared in the couple's joy, including Sibavili's nephew, Luyanda Magubane.
It was nice to see my uncle happy and my aunt. Yeah, it was nice seeing them very happy together.
The groom is known to family and friends for his sense of humor. But when it came to his vows, you could see the emotion.
The ceremony was special, especially when they said their vows. They were absolutely just stunning. They were short, but they were cute.
I found the most amazing part of the day was watching her walk across the altar, and he was just smiling the whole time. That was nice to see.
Knox was at last a member of the Magubane family and welcomed with open arms by Mpume Mjwara.
Mpume, you are Sibavili's sister. What was he like growing up?
Very, very naughty. But then for some reason as well, he was the one who was telling the parents whatever we did. But he was the naughtiest out of all of us.
Well, Sibavili was a very young boy, a very young naughty boy. And his brother, Usihle, and so on. But they were very disciplined. What was good about them, that they liked the school, they were young people who were really listening to their parents. And therefore, that's why I'm not surprised that they've grown up to this stage. They've worked hard for this day.
You've known Spabili since he was a little boy. It must be amazing to see him throw this amazing party.
Magubane, we know him as a very young boy. He grew up in front of us, especially me. And then the wife is a Ngobo. So beautiful Ngobo women. He got attracted as I did get attracted. So the relationship is that he grew under us, but besides, there are relationship between the wives.
The entertainment included Vusi Nova, Big Nas, the Afro Tenors, DJ Muntu, and Mikasa.
So what is it like for you guys to perform at weddings like this? I mean, you perform across the world, literally.
We've always said that playing at weddings is quite an honor, man, you know. To think that someone would want us to come and, you know, entertain for their special day, it means quite a lot to us. It's such a special thing to share with the Magubane.
Sibabili also sang the classic Stand By Me, which his bride found immensely entertaining.
What do you guys look forward to the most in starting this new journey in your lives?
Starting a family.
No restaurants. Eating at home.
Cooking at home. You know why? Because we've been together for 11 years, so I don't see any points for us to wait now any longer. I think I know him, he knows me. We just, we're ready.
Yeah.
Well, I've had an absolutely amazing time and the entertainment was on point. So well done to you guys. And we wish you from Toppling the absolute best.
Thank you
so much.
No,
thanks a lot. Thank you.
Still to come, meet the wine farmers whose secrets to an award-winning Chenin Blanc include playing classical music to their vines.
Many summer weddings showcase top local wines, and forging a global name for one particular South African wine is the Standard Bank Chenin Blanc Top 10 Challenge. Next, winning winemaker Carl van Amava shows that the prize money is also making a difference in the lives of staff and their community.
Carl gets to call this his office, the De Morgan Zone Estate. The first part of the Stellenbosch Kloof Valley to see the sun every morning. The wine made here is the product of 13 years of investment by owners Wendy and Hilton Applebaum.
You're one of South Africa's most successful women in business. What drew you to owning a vineyard?
I always wanted to live on a farm. And I do believe that if you do something that you really enjoy, I love wine, and so it was kind of logical that it would be a vineyard that I would land up living on and making something that I enjoyed.
In such a short space of time, you've already created award-winning wines. What's the philosophy behind your success?
Well, firstly, I have to say that there's a certain amount of luck. So we farm very differently here. We put no rubbish into the vineyards. We try and do absolute organic farming. We have beautiful gardens, which not only look beautiful, but actually encourage insects into the environment. We have birds of prey, we have pedestals for them. We encourage an entire environment that brings on beautiful grapes. Also, the winemaker Carl is a brilliant winemaker, but he has lots of toys and absolutely no excuses not to deliver the most delicious wines.
Grapes have been grown here for more than 300 years. Carl van der Merwe finds that the altitude between 200 and 400 meters offers a cool climate with low humidity, ideal for producing wines of personality, fruit, and flavor.
You know, so what we're looking for at this time of the year is the color of the berries. So we're looking for berries that are nice and yellow. These vineyards have carried this fruit for the last, you know, for the last 4 months. They're now actually at full term. You know, so they're ready to release their fruit. Now's the time we're picking, and I mean, the flavor's just amazing.
Wow, I just taste sugar. It's really sweet. What do you taste?
Well, you can taste the hints of apricot and peach. If you chew on the skins, there's a little fine dryness, which means the wine's gonna have nice texture.
part of winning the Standard Bank Top 10 Challenge means that the prize money must benefit employees and their families.
The best part about this is that your prize money goes to a good cause.
Yeah, you know, it's quite a funny story. I was at university with a girl called Anna Brom, and she had this great idea that with local children to actually reward them with running. So they would be incentivized, in a sense, to read books, and by the time they'd read a certain number of books, they were then allowed to enter a local running race. It's a fantastic program. The children are just showing such great development at school, and it's a project I really believe in. And personally, we believe that education is the key to development. So hence we decided to give the money to a children-based initiative.
I've heard music played through the vineyards the whole day.
Hilton Applebaum, Wendy's husband, was the founder of Classic FM. And he came with the crazy idea to play music to vines. And you know, Hilton's crazy enough, and he went and erected 9 speakers in the vineyards and put together 2,000 classical and baroque songs onto a playlist. And this music plays 24 hours a day. And I must say, I've seen a difference in the various blocks, the blocks that are exposed directly to music versus the blocks that grow a little bit further away from the music. The exact difference is difficult to quantify scientifically. But then again, you know, at De Morgan's End, we believe that when you surround yourself with beautiful things and you try to beautify your area and you do things in a beautiful way, ultimately, when you're dealing with creative things like wine, it's going to be beneficial to the quality at the end of the day.
So music makes for fine Chenin Blanc. As more wine lovers develop a taste for it, wine farming communities benefit. And that is what Standard Bank want to invest in.
This place is amazing. I love that fruity, oaky smell that you have in the air. What is it that sets your wine apart from the rest?
You know, Chris, great wine is always produced on the sides of mountains. And as you saw when you were outside, the sloping vineyards create the most incredible place to grow grapes. And this, at the end of the day, produces fantastic wine. And wines of intensity, wines of richness, and a lovely long length for perfect aging.
Why did Standard Bank decide to get involved with the Chenin Blanc Top 10 Challenge?
Chenin Blanc is a grape that is truly South African by virtue of its plantings, the length of time that it has been in South Africa, and we own 2/3 of the world's greatest white wine grape. And Standard Bank is proud to be associated with an event that aims to celebrate and honor the finest Chenin Blanc wines produced in our country.
What are your thoughts about the future of Chenin Blanc in South Africa?
The future generation of producers, wine producers, will work even harder to uphold the status by innovating and producing Chenin Blanc wines of the highest quality and standards. There is no question that the Standard Bank Chenin Blanc Top 10 Challenge is a benefit to South Africa, and we need to go out to the front lines with it.
To the leaders at the front line, cheers.
You can find quite a story in a glass of wine. Cheers, South Africa, and thank you for keeping us company. Until next Thursday at 7:30, right here on 3, good night and God bless.
Join us again next week for more celebrity romances that went from Will You Be My Valentine to Will You Be My Wife. Akona Ndungane took 9 years to wed gorgeous Siyanda Stofile, but their love never faltered. Jurgen Fissa is so glad he chose to simply say hello to the stunning Minette Toller. And a shared love of helping others brings lasting happiness to Peter Shivute and the radiant Dumi Sisulu.